Welcome to this video on how to set up an Autodesk Fusion hub so that you can collaborate with your team efficiently. I'm Ollie, I'm an Autodesk certified instructor, and I'm going to be taking you through the workflow, both from an administrator's point of view and from a day-to-day worker's point of view. We're going to be going through all of the web pages and emails so that you'll see an end-to-end experience of how it goes, what you need to look out for, and how you can end up ready to get designing on Fusion. We're going to start with the point of view of an administrator. Now, as an administrator, you're someone who is setting up this process for everybody in your company. You might not be using Fusion directly yourself, but you've been tasked with setting it up and getting everybody up and running in one Fusion hub. Now, for the purposes of this video, we're going to be assuming that you've already created an Autodesk account and that you have already purchased the number of licenses that you require for your company. After that though, we're going to go through every step that you need to get your team all working together. As the administrator, you have three key steps to complete in order to onboard your team. First, you need to create the new Fusion Hub. Then you invite everybody to it. And finally, you need to assign Fusion licenses to all of your workers. Let's start right from the very beginning. When you open Fusion for the first time, it will prompt you to sign in. When you do that, it'll take you to your browser to prompt that sign in. And once you've signed in, you can then go to product to open that in the downloaded version. Now, because this is your first time signing into Fusion, it'll prompt you with a welcome message and walk you through the process of setting up your account. So we can click next, and it's prompting me to either create a team or join an existing team. Now, because this is the first time using Fusion for me, I don't have an existing team to join, so I'm going to create a new team. And in here, it's prompting me for a team name or a hub name. So I'm going to put in probably your company's name or something that's going to be recognizable to all of your workers. When you press next, you're able to allow or not allow discovery, but allowing discovery will allow others with your email domain to be able to find that team if they sign up to Fusion in the same way that you are. Because of the fact that I have a generic email on this account, I'm not allowed to enable discovery. But when you use your company's domain, you will have this option to allow discovery. And when you click create, it will set up your Fusion hub and you can open it within Fusion. So when I click go to team, it'll ask me a bit of information, but I can go through and open up Fusion. Now, after all of the different introductory sections, you can say I'm taken to the home tab within Fusion where all my data would be stored. Now, I should note at this point that I don't actually have a license on this account. You don't have to have a valid Fusion license to complete this. You as the administrator, who might not be using Fusion yourself, can still set up a Fusion hub and assign licenses to your team without having one yourself. Now, I've got here my hub name on the left-hand side. And actually, a lot of the work we're going to do is going to be much easier in the online version of Fusion Team or Fusion Hub. So I'm going to click these three dots and go into my team settings. And this will open your browser and show you your Fusion Team viewer in the browser. Now, it'll give you some introductory messages. And from there, you can make some changes to your team. Now, we're currently in the team admin section. If you don't go through the main Fusion viewer like we just did, you can also access this by clicking on your photo or your icon at the top right, and then pressing admin, and it will take you to the admin of that hub. Now, in here, I can change some of my settings if I want to, but the key part really is these tabs at the top, where we can move on to step two, inviting the workers and people that you want inside of your hub. So let's go into the members and roles section. And you'll see yourself here, as the owner and team administrator, but we want to bring more people in here. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to press invite. And I can enter the email address of the workers that I want to invite into our Fusion Hub. Now you can enter as many as you like with commas. I'm only going to add one to now just as a demonstration. But when you add those people in, you can press invite. So now that that invite has been sent successfully, I can go out of there and I can actually see any pending, and in this case, sent invitations to see what the status of them is. So let's go over and talk to Liz, who is the worker that I've just invited, and she's going to run us through what she receives as an email and what the process looks like from her point of view.
So I can see in my emails that I've been invited by Ollie, my company's administrator, to join this Fusion team. So I'm going to click on the Join Team button. And immediately, it's recognised that this email address does not already have an associated Autodesk account, so it's prompting me to create a new one. Now, if I had previously created an Autodesk account with that email, then it would just take you straight through and prompt you to sign in. And having now created an account and logged in, it's taken me straight into the hub that my administrator has created, and it's given me the introductory information. I can see here that we have some default projects and some assets, and these are the standard projects that come every time a new hub is created. Before I get modelling anything, I should check with my administrator how we plan to organise our data. I've also noticed that Fusion has sent me another email informing me that I've successfully been added to the Fusion Hub. Now, as the worker, I can open Fusion on my computer if it has already been installed, or I can download it myself by clicking on the Download Now in the banner on the Fusion Team webpage. Then I go through the sign-in process where, because I'm already signed in, it's recognised that, and I can click Go to Product. And it will open my version of Fusion. Now go through the initial setup sets, and I can learn about Fusion's capability. Once I'm taken to the Home tab and I successfully have access to my company's Fusion Hub. Now I can see that in the top right, I have the Subscribe Now button, which tells me that I'm still in trial mode. But I know that Ollie, my administrator, will be giving me a full license, so I don't need to worry about that for now.
Now you might not have spotted it, but I've just shown you one of the key advantages of not giving your worker a license at the first step. By inviting them to the Fusion Hub first, it means that when they first sign into Fusion, they're not prompted to create their own team. As the administrator, you want all of your workers' data and information for your company to be stored in one place, the hub that you have created. And by inviting them to that hub that you created first, they are far less likely to create their own team or hub and have company data stored outside of where you want it in their own personal area. Now, as the team administrator, I can go back onto my Fusion Team Hub on the online viewer, and I can see that in my members and roles section of the admin page, I can see that my company worker has joined this hub. They joined 17 minutes ago, and they are a team member. It's important to note that just because somebody's a team member doesn't necessarily mean they have full access to all the data in your hub. You may need to add them, or they can request access to individual projects if you're not using the open type of project. Now, if I wanted to, I could choose to make them a team administrator. So if there was somebody else that you wanted to have the privileges to invite other members and roles and adjust the team settings, then that's absolutely possible, and you can assign them as a team administrator. So now that my workers are all in the Fusion Hub, it's time to assign them a license so that they can get cracking with their work. To do this, I'm going to go to a separate management portal called manage.autodesk.com. You can find the link to this both up above right now and down in the description below. Now I'm going to go into this Buy Product button, which will take me to show me all of the different licenses that I've purchased and can assign. Now, in my case, I have the base version of Fusion. Plus, I have actually purchased a number of the extensions, and these are separate licenses that you can distribute in exactly the same way to specific team members. But if I click on the Fusion here, I can see that I have no assigned users yet. There's nobody that I've given these licenses to, but I've purchased 5 seats. So I have 5 potential people that I can give this to right now. And what I can do is I can press assign users, and you can either, if there's a larger number here, import users to assign through a CSV file, or I can type in their name or email and they'll show up here on this list. And this is another advantage of inviting somebody to your Fusion Hub first. It means that they're in the system with their account already set up. So when you come to this stage, they will just show up here and I can add the license to them. If you haven't invited them to the hub yet, then before you're able to assign this, you'll have to invite that user to create a new account and invite them to your manage team to be able to assign them a license, which is a couple of extra steps. So now I can assign my worker a license, and it will show up here in my assigned users list. I could, if I wanted to, also do management by user, where I can define the exact licenses that one specific user will have, or I can create groups with the by group section to have different groups of workers or employees that have different assigned licenses altogether, making your life a lot easier as the administrator. So let's now swap over again for the last time to our worker and see what emails they've received and how they can make sure that their license is activated.
As the worker, I have received an email from noreply@autodeskcommunications.com saying that I've been assigned a license. If I did not get this email, I should check the junk folder of my emails or let my administrator know to whitelist the Autodesk email domains on our email system. I can see all the licenses that I've been given here, and I can click Get Your Software. And this will open up the manage.autodesk.com page. From here, I can see the different types of licenses that are available, and I could, for example, download Fusion onto my computer if I still needed to download it, or if, in the future, I want to download it onto a new device. Now, the next time that I sign into Fusion, or when I open it up, it should recognize that license and I will no longer be on a trial license. You can see that my Subscribe Now option has disappeared at the top, and I have full access to Fusion within my company's hub and all of the data that is associated with it. I can now crack on with designing the parts that I need to design, and every time I save them, I will be taken into that same set of projects, all within our company hub. So all of the data that I will save will be in the same location as all of the other workers in my company, and I'm able to collaborate with them on shared files and make sure that everything we're doing is visible to one another. On top of that, any time that I download Fusion or sign in on another computer, I will have access to all of my data in the cloud. In the end, as the worker, I had to complete 2 key tasks prompted by 2 emails. Join our company's Fusion Hub, create an account in the process, and then accepting the license that had been assigned to me.
It very much depends on your company structure. Some companies will have administrators set up what are called projects in Fusion, which are essentially high-level and permission-based folders that you can store all of your data in. In other companies, it might be up to the workers to complete this. However, it is important that you have some organizational system set up from the get-go so that things don't get all disorganized. I hope the process to set up your Fusion team with all of your workers is now incredibly straightforward, and I look forward to seeing you in the